Hello and welcome back to Avorion. My name is Spanj. Welcome to back into the corporation space. This is all the way back in Neonite space. This is actually my brand new scrap metal trader. And I've also got the solar power plant here, the silicon mine here, and somewhere around here is a coal mine. There it is. So today, with these four factories set up, I've still got a bunch more factories to set up for the transformator factory to run, fine without a problem. However, what I'm going to do today is actually set up the transformator factory itself. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to interact with the shipyard here and get it to build a single block vessel. That'll do fine. And ship and crew, please give it a station founder block. Yeah, and build that. You have to give your ship a name. Of course I do. Transformator. The Transformator. Transformator. So there we go. That should be along as soon as that bar has reached the top. Then I'm just going to transform it into a Catler, I think. Park it over here somewhere. And turn it into our Transformator station. Here we are then. Far enough away from all of the stations to not be a problem. And we are going to what are we going to do? We are going to found a mine, aren't we? So sorry, found a station. We can just shift and click found station here. Now I think it's a advanced, not a high tech, but it could be wrong. We'll just scroll through this. T's or transformators. There we go. Literally, it's only 5 million credits for a transformator factory. I'm hoping that they're a reasonable profit. To be honest, I don't know. Transformators, the reason I've chosen transformators is because it's not overly complicated and it is in high demand here. It is probably one of the highest demand advanced factories in this area. So we're going to go ahead and do that. Lovely. And then we're going straight into build and we're going to apply the Omni Station design. The same as the other ones, but I am going to adjust it up to a 10 socket beast. I might even make it even bigger after that as well. That should give us decent hull and shield for this area, at least, anyway. Always good to sort of build your stations in sort of safer or lower tech space, I think, to be honest, because then it's not... your trade stations, at least your money makers, that is not going to attract attention that can't be dealt with, you know? So there we go. Omni station number... I don't know, 4, isn't it now? So we can transfer, we can modify the entire ship, we can scale it up again if we want to. Give it another 30%, for example. That will give us even more mass, even more shields. Another 5 million credits, of course. But there we go. We'll see, what we're trying to do is get the hull and the shield up to a nice level. Okay, so this is a transformator factory. Let's take a look at it, shall we? So this thing, in order to function, needs steel, plastic, silicon, silver, and energy cells in order to produce one transformator, which it will sell at plus 30 its going rate, 281. So but we can see here that at the moment silver is, well, 208. Wow. Base price factor in regional supply and demand. Okay, but well, this produces 10 transformators, sorry, not one. The silicon is 606. The plastic, 106,336, blah, 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 blah. So we've already got the silicon mine, okay? We've already got the solar power plant. So we can definitely get those two supplying this station so it doesn't need to buy expensive energy cells and it doesn't need to buy expensive silicon. So those guys, I think we can just tell them to supply local station. Where is it? That was the scrap metal. The frick of my other stations. There we go. This is the solar power plant. Let's have a look at that. So I think we can tell it to sell goods to other actively requests. We can remove sell goods to others. And we can say deliver goods to stations. We could say don't sell. Deliver goods to the transformator factory. I guess if we could sell as well. I'm not sure if it produces enough. I don't know how many it needs. Let's leave that as it is for now, right? So it's... that's quite good. It's gained 70 million. It's gained so far. It's pretty good, isn't it? For a little solar cell factory. People were like, don't buy solar cells. It's a waste of money. I challenge ye that it not be. Okay. I just figure this out. So I don't know how many solar cells does it take. Energy cells. Just one. It takes one energy cell. So actually, it's there's my solar power plant is going to have way more friggin' energy cells than it can deliver to the one transformer factory there. For now. I mean, at some point, I'm going to be like, yeah, okay. So sell goods to others, I'm going to leave on. Station will sell to traders from other factions than you. And we can sell it to actively sell, but it's also going to deliver solar cells to the transformer factory. Lovely. So, here we go. Now we can do the same with the silicon mine, wherever that is. There it is. Let's quickly switch over to you. And we can say deliver goods to the transformer factory. There we go. Okay. Now, there is a... there is another way, a somewhat more efficient way of transferring goods between the stations. But it is, I am told, extremely fiddly. And that is to dock all your the substations to your one station. Now, I need two steels, one plastic, one silicon, one silver. So we can discount the silicon and the energy cell for now. Silver is a noble metal mine. Plastic needs to come from an oil refinery, which means it needs to be supplied with crude oil from an oil rig. And steel, two steel factories, need to be supplied by scrap metal, I guess. So we've got a scrap metal trader here already. There is this wonderful, wonderful website that the guys told me about on Discord. It's fantastic, and I'll link, I'll put the address in the video description down below. And it simply just tells you what factories you need to supply an end factory. You put in the end factory and then you tell it to autofill the required factories, and it'll tell you how many you need to run one transformative factory or whatever it is, what mines you need, everything in between. It's brilliant. It's so bloody useful. So I'll link that down below. You'll find it useful. So that's gonna run now. We're gonna have to put some crew in it, of course, and we should hopefully start seeing some profit maybe from this thing here. So we're gonna buy goods from others, sell goods to others, actively request goods and actively sell goods, fetch goods from stations. Let's do it. Solar power plant and the silicon mine. There we are. Now if it was docked, I think it would do that automatically. But there we go. So profit production, it's already made 1,000. Nice. I don't know how it's managed to do that. Oh, it has it. That's the average amount of profit per production. Okay, cool. There we go. Fine. We're going to leave it to do its thing. Let's hire the crew we need in order for this thing to not fall apart. We're going to need about all of those. And let's request a freaking transport, shall we? So your crew transport is on the way. We'll be here in about 30 seconds. Lovely. Here we go. We need 106 freaking mechanics. I know that costs 148 credits, but whatever. We want the crew. So crew is on the way. We shouldn't need an insurance plan because this is safe space. I don't imagine anything to come here that's going to cause any problems whatsoever. And so the final thing to do is to equip some modules in here for security, like turrets and stuff like that. And then we should be good. We got ourselves a transformer to factory. Over the next... Over time, I'll add the rest of the factories in, which means towing some asteroids into this and setting up noble metal and oil rigs, oil refineries, and so on and so forth. Yeah, crew transport. Nice. 30 seconds, my ass. Like 5 minutes. You know, my station is taking like a massive amount of damage while I'm waiting for those bastards to arrive. Anyway, the point is we'll need many more stations to make this completely like the most profitable it can be. At the moment, it's going to be marginally profitable. And then that's it. We'll also need to modify the living bejesus out of this station in order to... look at it. We've gained a bunch of energy cells. We've gained silicon. We've gained steel. We gained more silicon. The station's just bought a bunch of stuff off that ship there that just docked. Kind of cool. I think we're going to get a lot of traffic here. So the base price... is minus 7. I'm going to ramp that up to 5. So that will attract... Generally, that will attract more sellers, right? Than buyers. But the demand for transformers are so high in this sector. Look at plus 30 here. That I think it'll be fine. I think it'll be fine. And here's our crew transport docking now. Lovely. Okay, good. There we have it. We have a transformator station now. I've given it some turrets. I've given it all tracking missile turrets. and a few little point defenses as well. That's the random ass modules I've given it. It's got impenetrable shields, which means that it's almost 2 million shields is now only 642k, but it means that occasional sort of torpedo or whatever damage that might come along hopefully won't damage the station. I haven't had any problems with that so far, but it'll be interesting to see now as it gains more and more silicon and energy cells from my local stations how it does. Got a lot of energy cells, a lot of silicon, not so many transformers, 1200. So it'd be interesting to see now that we've got this thing up running, if it is as profitable as I hope it to be. I'm sure you guys in the comments can help out, everyone, about what stations are most profitable. I hear good things about processor factories. I do, but they are slightly more complicated, and I think other players have already kind of satisfied that demand around here. What's really important when you're setting up a station is to check the trading overview, and even if there's supply, check the difference in demand to supply. So this number here is really important, because if there's high demand and high price, you're golden. You're absolutely golden. Even if there is a supply, you can see energy cells, for example, here. There's a supply of 167.5 in this area, but there's a demand for 313. The difference is 145. The price is high as a result. This is what I mean. So energy cells, steel, biogas, processors are actually pretty good here as well, in fairness. Carbon power units, transformers up there. And then, you know, everything else is kind of like sort of starting to go down into the difference here, and becoming, some of these are quite simple things as well, like the silicon, for example, is just a mine. So pay attention to this if you want to see what station you want to set up to get the most money out of, to sell the most. Some stations are more profitable than others, of course. Power energy cells, they cost nothing apart from the initial setup of the station. They just produce that, and it's the same with anything that's like a mine. Silicon, water, they will just produce that. You don't have to put any goods into it, but they don't make a huge amount of money you know, in one hit, but they will make a lot of money over time. There we go, transformer station. So like I said, what I'll do is over time I will set up more and more stations to make this more and more profitable, and that is going to be hopefully my main money maker. That's all the way down here in the Itumf Corporation, my allies. Lovely stuff. So now it's time to go all the way back up over here. Oh, one second, the Buccaneer has once again made me millions. Thank you, Buccaneer. You are, as always, profitable to the end. I tell you, there's the highest profit is a freaking trading captain and a ship with some cargo space. Now, the guys here, they don't have the biggest cargo spaces there is, by a long ways, but they can make a lot of money anyway. So imagine a ship with a huge amount of cargo space, trade systems, trade captain. You should be able to do some decent stuff, I think. Anyway, here we go. Laser heads, 1.3 million, 700,000, but three trips. So probably somewhere 2 million something. Microchips, 2.5 million, one trip. Easy, done, go, make it so. Have a good time. Right, back to the war spite then. And back to our campaign against the Zotan. First up, though, looks like we've got a distress signal. Now, these typically almost always end up as pirate ambushes, but I'm confident that we'll be fine if that is the case. And if it's not, and it is genuinely a ship in distress, then, well, we'll be happy to lend our assistance. Let's go, boys. Well, look at this. It is, a fake distress call worked. Well, did it though? Did it? Because look at the mess you've gotten yourself into now. Alright, let's have some defending squadrons out here, shall we? Let's get this guy down. What torpedoes have we got today? There's like plasma and EMP. Oh, the fighters are going to make short work of that guy anyway, so. Phalanx Corvette moving. Hey! Jesus Christ, dude! Learn to fly! Oh, he's running! Look at him run! He's off! Oh no, that's just weird lag. Alright, well, have some torpedoes. You know. Bang, bang, and bang. This guy is Savage Raider. He's got some freaking hit points here, isn't he? How many other pirate ships we got around? There's two by the look of it. This guy will not die. He will now. That leaves one pirate left. Everybody? Back over here. We get to pick up your fighters, yeah? Oh, you killed it already. Never mind. Never mind. I was going to be like, hey, let's board it. Let's have some fun, yeah? Well, I was hoping to maybe get a little boarding action on that last ship there, but it looked like my escort fleet there just absolutely wrecked it. Like, seriously. I suppose in hindsight, the Savage Raider would have been a good choice. It's interesting, though, these fake distress signals, though. Actually, it's not a pirate sector, so it could be a good candidate for perhaps trying to board something and getting ourselves a new ship as a result. However, this particular occasion, it didn't work out. Anyway, let's get those ships back in over here now that I've just told them all to go away. Get them back. I told them to go away for one reason. That reason is no longer valid, so come back here, boys. I'll get you salvaging, and we'll use the Corvette to go around and mop up all these shiny things. Jesus, that was close. But of course the Zotan would come in while I'm doing my salvaging business. I mean, that just makes perfect sense, doesn't it? I'm in the Corvette! Not in the right ship for this. But the Corvette has got auto-fire Tesla cannons. Ooh, you got some big boy cannons. Take my zappy zappy. Take it. Take it. Back here. Yes. Now, you guys alright? Yeah. It was only a small party of Zotan, so nothing too worried about. Nice! Very good. And some more shinies for me to pick up on the way. Good job, guys. Good job. Keep up the salvaging. Wonderful stuff. Something quite majestic about watching a bunch of salvage fighters just absolutely tear a wreck apart. So quick. They're done. They're done. We only just got here. Pirates, of course. But of course. What are they attacking? Okay. Alright. Number one. Everybody, on me. With the Corvette. This will be interesting. Hello. I've just fucking autopiloted myself. Where's the big boy? There you are. Escort me as well. I'm going to stay in the Corvette. This will be fine. It'll be fine. The guys are kind of struggling a bit on their own, though. Let's go. Pirate scam. Suffer my Tesla cannons in a second, you sunshine. I can get close enough, of course. Lovely. Oh, look at the lasers. Did you guys make a mistake? I think you did, didn't you? Teslas? Yeah, good lads. Right. Thanks to salvaging. It's honestly, the sector just keeps filling itself up with more and more salvage. It's quite an interesting loop. Oh, I just set off an alarm. Yeah, I'm out here on my own as well, so this is going to be interesting. Let's see how we get on. Some pirates have arrived. Okie dokie then. Alright. Into this, I want to have a new ship. Marauder. Whatever that is. Raider. Marauder. Savage Pirate. He's our target then. Let's work. Alright, let's get rid of this guy first. Let's see. We're in range on some of our weapons already. Of course, there is entirely possible that our laser systems will simply just evaporate anything that comes along. Right, that guy is going down. He's down, right. But the Savage Pirate is still okay. Get rid of his friends. That should leave just Savage Pirate. So let's turn off our laser systems here. We don't want... Oh, no, 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 no. Don't run away. Don't run away. No. Coward. Ooh, wait, more. It's not over yet. In that case, guys, as you were, yeah. Ooh, lasers. I need to turn my frickin' defense system back on, don't I? That would help, wouldn't it? Okie dokie. Let's try this again, shall we? Alright, one down. Taking some minor block damage. Somebody's lobbing a lot of torpedoes at me today, aren't they? Okay. That lagged out heavily, and then he disappeared. Okay, another bunch of ships have arrived. Fine. Savage Disruptor. Next. Shields are doing a fantastic job at the moment of barely even moving. Which I love. It's fantastic. What are the fighters doing? They're doing alright. Oh, we got a big artillery boy off the left. Tell you what, guys. Go get him. Look at these other fools. I'm guessing by the fact that that guy stopped firing at me that he's dead. Nope. What are you doing, fighters? Come on, get him. Take it too long. Alright, is this the last guy? No, there's one over there, look. The Raider. Alright, any more that want to come in? I think so. The Raider is... Oh no, yep, here they come. never mind. Back on defensive duties, boys. We got this. Okay, this has got to be like final freaking round. I don't know. None of those guys have got point defense, have they? Well, such a shame that if they just got torpedoed. I can play torpedoes too, you know. Lamb. I think only two landed. Same. Oh, he's got all lightnings and stuff. None of that, thank you. Are you lot all staying at range because you think that's safer? Is that what that is? Okay. Well, seriously, point defense. What are you doing? You having a little nap? You having a nap, are you? Your little sleepy sleeps? What's going on? Oh, just look at those fighters. They're just laying into him big style. Here he goes. Right. Oh, they killed the merchant ship. You miserable little bastards. Fires! Go get him. He's a savage marauder. Actually, fighters, go get the raider. We want the savage marauder. Thank you. Point defense. It's like shopping for ships, isn't it? Wait. Yeah. My shields are fully recharged now. Hopefully this guy, like, we'll get him down and the others will stay and I'll just, like, bug out. There he goes. Right, okay. So, this guy is, he's just a raider. We're not interested in him. We're interested in this guy here, okay. So no more have come along, which is good. Let's have the fighters back in on board. Let's go. And we are just going to take this guy down bit by bit until we're ready to send borders in. Meanwhile, he's going to continue to lob torpedoes at us, I assume. Guys, well done. Good work. It's a very slow and methodical process. This is the plan. It's going to work beautifully. Flawlessly. Right, there we go. He's ready for borders. Borders. Go. Have at him, boys. Boarding ships are on the way. Just four of them. Boarding ships have arrived. Commencing boarding. Yes! Entering. We can back out of range of that missile barrage. Battling 32 security. I've lost one. So the red bar is me. The blue bar is them. I lost two. Ooh, this is very much. This is 17 security. Oh, I'm not liking that. Red bar is just reducing. Come on, guys. 5 security. Yes! It worked! Oh. No! You gotta be kidding me! What the hell? That's ridiculous! We suspect you absolute dick. What? What a dick. What an absolute dick. Ah, oh, he's so annoyed. So that... it's got to be the last ship in the system then, otherwise they just bring in more ships and blow it up instantly. Alright, here we go then. This is getting serious now, isn't it? Alright, let's have a bit of backup, shall we? Items deploy, lag spike. Chicken boys. Boarded that ship. Boarded that ship. It was fine. It was absolutely golden. I was like, yeah, I got a ship. How do I know if it's the last wave? We're just gonna like tiptoe these ships until like there's only one left and no more reinforcements comes in. That's what I gotta do, isn't it? Oh, that torpedo warning's getting a bit tiresome. I have three torpedoes then. If you wanna play freaking torpedoes, let's do it. Ah, for crying out loud. So while pirates are attacking the sector, pirates attack the sector. This is getting stupid. Ramming speed. Unbelievable. All right. Kind of auto turrets, it's up to you now really, because there's a target rich environment, so get on with it. Yeah, shoot everything, bastards. Hey, bastards come from. I want the tough raider for myself, so I'm going to leave him alone. I hope my auto turrets don't just blow him up. Boom, have that. Yatch. Savage Bandit, Tough Raider. I don't know which one's best. Let me pick one of them. Tough Raider is on lower health, so let's get for him. Good for him. Alright, boys. Tag him. Get him. Stick him. Get him. Get him. I will get a ship out of this. I am so determined. I'm just hoping I've got enough borders left over. That last thing. He's fine. He's still got shields. He's alright. Good old ramming speed. It's a giggle, isn't it? Right, everybody, back to me now. This guy, then, he's our target. Sector cleared, finally. So he's like the last one of the pirate attack on this sector? I don't know. I didn't even know if the borders are going to work again, because. Like I said, I don't even know if I've got enough borders. A little bit more. A little bit more. Got to be ready now. It's a problem, isn't there? They're very fast. Yay! Damn it. Damn it! I killed them all! Freaking killed them all, man. I'm just gonna have to sit here until, like... He's either taken my shields down or I've trained enough boarders that I can activate the boardy group. Board. No. No crew. No, well, no shit. They all went over to another ship. They got instantly deleted. Oh my god, this takes like half an hour per thing, doesn't it? I can't auto-assign regular crew to be boarders. They have to be trained crew. Oh man. Do you know how annoying that was? I thought, yay, we boarders! Delete. Denied. It's so crap. You have to get the ships down on such low health. Oh man. Well, there we go. Well, there we go. The last ship is down. Never mind. There is many, many shinies, though, that need to be collected. So, I guess what I'll do... Bring the boys over. Brigand! Travel! Yeah! And bring with you everyone, please. Be quick about it. 6 minutes. 6 minutes. What's taking you so long? 6 minutes. Unbelievable. Six. Yeah. Anyway, there's some shinies around. There's an exotic somewhere. There it is. You'll get that now. I've also got a message. Somebody has messaged me. Let's do it. You did it. You actually boarded another ship and killed all of the freaking... I'll take the money. Thank you. 100,000 credits. Delicious. Killed all of my boarders due to a miscalculation. They all died. It wasn't my fault. Freaking pirates. He should have come in. I didn't realize there was a pirate sector as well, because it was, pretty sure it was empty when I got here. No, it was, distress signal, wasn't it? That's strange. Oh, well. Oh, yay, transporter software. That's exciting. Get out of my way. Okay. Well, ladies and gentlemen, there we go. Boarding, once again, unsuccessful. I will. One of these days... get a freaking ship. I'm getting sort of more and more of an idea of what is required. Piss off, aliens. And that is unbelievable delicacy and patience. is unreal. You have to get the ship down to less than 30%, right? It's basically on its last legs when you send your crew over to it. Which means if there's a battle going on around it, it ain't got a chance. It's gonna die, right? Because as soon as it becomes yours, everything's gonna shoot it and destroy it, as we just saw. Which means it has to be the last ship in the sector. I might be able to quickly do these Zotan ones, actually. Could get a hardcore Zotan, bet. That's the one I want. Savage. Or just a regular Zotan, bet. Hey. Frick these guys. They're mine. Go get them, boys. Lag spike. Every time you deploy fighters, it's just like... absolute lagathon. Right, I can only have one of these, so this guy's gonna die because he's basically dead. And that guy is the last one alive, so we'll turn everything off and bring these guys home. We're going to delicately, ever so delicately, carve this guy up. Oh, I can't, I haven't got any boarders, what are we doing? Actually, I was just saying, all my boarders are dead. And then I'm like, hey, let's board. Yeah, let's do it. Yeah, no, got no boarders. Get him. Unbelievable idiocy from me. I apologize. But I'm going to have to wait a while before my borders are repopulated. And we can try it again. But I think that would be the ideal situation if there were just like three Zotan ships loitering around. That's assuming I can board a Zotan ship. Anyway, I want to board a ship. And I want to call it mine. And I want to take it home and like make it, fix it up. Make it all shiny. And all those things. You know? It will happen. It will happen. But it is not this day. In this day, we just laid waste to many a pirates and many a Zotan. And this ship, by the way, Victory Class Battle Carrier, is now available on the Steam Workshop in all of its glory and finery for you to enjoy. I'll put the link down below. It's pretty good. If I may say so myself, it did pretty well then. I have got some excellent modules in it, though. Just a word to the wise. They are my modules. many legendaries, many exotics, and many exceptionals make up the awesomeness of this ship. With those modules in it though, we've got 20 million shields, 1.82 million hull points, and that many turrets and guns. Oh, what is the firepower rating? 40 omicrons of firepower at the moment, which, you know, can go up as soon as we actually start getting nice turrets and being able to manufacture them and keep a station alive for more than 5 seconds in the center of the galaxy. There we are. The Victory Class Battlecruiser. It's just, yeah, I'm very happy with it and the way it performs. Not to mention, it's got back. So there we go. Ladies and gentlemen, that is going to be all for today. Thank you very much for watching. I do hope you enjoyed. And hopefully, I will see you next time. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.